Hello students, welcome back to my grammar class. In this class, you are going to learn about direct and indirect speech. Today you are going to learn about direct and indirect speech. Okay? Direct and indirect speech is also known as direct and indirect narration. Direct and indirect narration. You are going to learn about what is narration, because if you clear with the topic, you can understand it. If you don't clear, if you haven't clear with the topic, then you don't understand this topic very clearly. Okay, topic pathi namba clear ah paakalam. What is narration? Yes, narration means an act of reporting the words of the speaker. Okay, narration means narration means the act of reporting the words of the speaker. Okay, for example, வந்து இப்ப நீங்க ஒரு மூவி பாத்துட்டு வரீங்கன்னா அது வந்து இப்ப நீங்க உங்க ஃப்ரெண்ட் கிட்ட சொல்லும்போது நீங்க நரேட் பண்ணுவீங்க. ஓகேங்களா, அங்க என்ன நடந்தது, அவங்க என்ன பேசினாங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லி நீங்க நரேட் பண்ணுவீங்களா. அது வந்து நீங்க என்ன பண்ணலாம், டூ வேஸ் நரேட் பண்ணுவீங்களா. ஒன்னு வந்து இந்த ஆக்டர் வந்து இந்த டைலாக் சொன்னாங்கன்ட்டு அந்த டைலாக் அப்படியே சொல்றது ஒண்ணு, இன்னொன்னு வந்து அந்த டைலாக் வந்து டிஃபரெண்டா மாடுலேட் பண்ணி உங்களுக்கு புரிஞ்சு நீங்க வந்து இப்ப சொல்ற மாதிரி இன்னொன்னு சொல்வீங்கல்ல. எஸ், தேர் ஆர் டூ வேஸ் ஆஃப் நரேஷன். ஒன் இஸ் டைரக்ட், அனதர் ஒன் இஸ் இன்டைரக்ட். இன்டைரக்ட் ஸ்பீச் means actual word the speaker are quoted as it is. Okay, the actual words to the sentence, the actual words of the speaker are quoted as it is. அப்படினா அவங்க என்ன சொன்னாங்களோ, இப்ப ஒரு ஸ்பீக்கர் என்ன சொன்னாங்களோ அதை அப்படியே நம்ம கேட்டு அந்த வேர்ட்ஸ்ல இருந்து என்ன சேஞ்சஸ் பண்ணாம நம்ம அப்படியே இன்னொருத்தவங்க கிட்ட சொல்றது. ஓகே, தட் இஸ் டைரக்ட் ஸ்பீச். அண்ட் வாட் இஸ் இன்டைரக்ட் ஸ்பீச் மா? எஸ், தி ஆக்சுவல் வேர்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஸ்பீக்கர் ஆர் ட்ரான்ஸ்ஃபார்ம்ட் ஆர் ரிப்போர்ட்டட். The actual words of the speaker are transformed. Transformed or change பண்ணி நம்ம இன்னொருத்தர்கிட்ட சொல்றது. Okay, have you understood the difference between the direct speech and the indirect speech? See here, for example, the servant said tea is ready. Look at the sentence. The servant said tea is ready. அப்படின்னும்போது அந்த சர்வன் வந்து சொல்றாங்க டீ ரெடி ஆயிடுச்சு அப்படின்னு சொல்றாங்க. So here this is this concept of direct speech. Yes, the servant said tea is ready. அவங்க அப்படியே தான் சொல்றாங்க. But see here, the servant said that tea was ready. The servant said that tea was ready. அப்படின்றது வந்து servant வந்து direct ஆ சொல்லல. வேற யார்கிட்ட சொல்லி இன்னொருத்தன் கிட்ட வந்து சொல்றது. Okay? Clear that? See here. Remember some points about your direct speech. Direct speech இப்படி தான் வரும். Okay? See here. This is a direct speech right? Look at the first part. The direct, the reported speech is put within the inverted commas. This is inverted comma, right? The reported speech is put within the inverted comma. Inverted comma na enna ma? Idhu da inverted comma. Okay, na reported speech na. This is reported speech here. Why I am saying that this is a reported speech? Yes, reported speech na avanga sonnada appadi solradhu. Okay, there is no changes in the words. So see that. The tea is ready. Here is a reported speech. And then first point is clear. And then second point, we use reported speech always begins with a capital letter. See here, this is reported speech, right? I told you this is reported speech. Now see here, the word tea. Okay, it's the first word. So always the reported speech begins with a capital letter. So I have started with a capital letter. And then third point, a comma is used to separate the reported speech and reporting speech. Now I told that T is ready. This is a reported speech. Now tell me, this is a reporting speech. Yes, the servant said. Is a reporting speech. Okay, the servant said. அப்படின்னும்போது அந்த reporting speech report பண்ணிட்டிருக்காங்க. But the T is ready. அப்படின்னும்போது reported speech. அப்படின்னா அவங்க சொன்ன words. There is no changes in the reported speech. So, I will clear with that. See here. Here, the servant said. Here, comma is there, right? Comma, which separates the reporting speech and the reported speech. Okay, clear with that. Comma, which separates the reporting speech and reported speech. This is the direct speech. Okay. And then see here, the reported speech is put within the inverted commas. So, always the reported speech in direct speech. Always put within the comma and the comma which separates the direct reporting verb, reporting speech and the reported speech. Okay, clear with that. And then reported speech always begins with the capital letter. Clear with that. And then look at these points. These are all comes under the indirect speech. The reported speech is introduced by the conjunction that. Okay, the reported speech is introduced by the conjunction that. Here, that is a conjunction, right? See here. The servant said. Same things. The servant said, I have wrote. And then, I added that. Okay. Here, we added comma because it is a reported speech. And we have to put that within the inverted commas. But the servant said that here is a conjunction. I have used to join. What is the conjunction mark? Yes, conjunction joins the sentences, phrases, etc. Right? The servant said that T. And this is an important speech, but you should not begin with the capital letter. Okay? That because there is no comma there, right? That T was ready. And then sentence. See. Tenses. Here is in a present tense. Then present tense changes into past tense. Here this is a verb. Yes. Was is a auxiliary verb, right? And then this changes into was. Clear with that? And then no comma is used after the said. Here we have used comma here, right? But here we should not use comma. For in case of comma, we are using that. Okay? Clear with that? The servant said that he was ready. Okay? Okay, students, are you clear with this? Shall we recall from the beginning? See here. What you are learning today? Yes, you are learning about the direct and indirect speech. Direct and indirect speech is also known as? Yes, direct and indirect narration. And then what is narration? Yes, the act of reporting the words of the speaker. Ungala speaker enna solranga adu vandu namma narrate pandradha narration. Okay? And then we can do the narration in two ways. First one is direct and then second one is indirect. What is direct? Yes, direct means the actual words of the speaker are quoted as it is. As it is na enna andha words vandu appadiye quote pandradhu. There is no changes in the word. And then, what is indirect speech? Yes, an actual words of the speaker are transformed. Okay, we are going to change those words. And then, for example, we have seen the servant said that tea is ready. And then, The tea is ready is a reported speech. The servant's hand is a reporting speech. These are the words you have to remember. That speech means that the reported speech is put within the inverted commas. Here, see here. This is reported speech. So we have put them in the inverted commas. And then reported speech always begins with a capital letter. Here, see here. T. And I begin with the capital letter. And then the comma is used to separate the reported speech and the reporting speech. Here, T is ready is a reported speech. And the servant said, here is a reporting speech. So we have used the comma to separate the reporting speech from the reported speech. Okay, have you clear with that? Now we are going to learn about the indirect speech. See here, the reported speech is introduced by the conjunction that. Okay, here we have used the comma, but we should not use comma in the indirect speech. We have to use the conjunction that. And then tense. Tense changes into the present tense into the past tense. And then no comma is used after said. Said the comma, we should not use any commas. So that we have to use that. Okay, students, I will share with this.